54?
Hey, my name is Garrett, and welcome to episode 54 of Attila's Trek. This is a devlog of my Tycoon game, Space Prevention Force, where your mission is to save alien lives by building, researching, and marketing your company. I will talk about my weekly game progress, show a little bit of my karate training, and we will
have fun.
So let's have some fun. On last week's video, a lot of you guys agreed that animation added a whole lot of polish to the game, so I added a little bit more. The aliens in the psychologist room will now bob up and down, as well as the selected worker icon. In addition, I added animated sliders over the research, marketing, and speaking buttons, although the speaking one doesn't work quite yet. Basically, the value of the slider over the button is the same as the one in the UI, but now you can always see your progress without needing the UI open. As someone who doesn't know Unity's animation system well and likes to brute force things to make them work, I eventually got this sort of working.
Well, how'd you do that?
How'd I do that? Warning, I am not a professional and I'm not suggesting that this is the best way to do it, but it is one way to do it. First, I made a UI slider that was slightly translucent over the original button. Similarly to the slider in the UI, I assigned the value of this slider to the research progress amount from 0 to 1. Side note, you can actually change the min and max bounds of a slider, so you don't always have to bound them between 0 and 1. When finished, an animation would be triggered, letting the player know that their upgrade or marketing campaign has finished. Because I'm using animation to control the slider's value, it prevented me from accessing and using this value in my scripts, even when it was in an idle animation state. So what I did is I added a behavior to the idle animation that would disable the animator whenever it was in that state. This let me regain control of the slider whenever I wanted to increase its value when the actual upgrade or campaign was underway, and it would animate afterwards whenever it was finished. The animation was pretty much the extent of the visible progress this week. That's because a lot of the progress I made was on the code of the research and marketing managers. Before, for each research upgrade or marketing campaign, I had several functions inside that would be matched to the corresponding upgrade or campaign. I would assign each button a certain function to execute, and this worked, but it wasn't very efficient since all the buttons had access to all the types of upgrades or campaigns. So what I did is I took all the functionality out of the upgrades and campaigns themselves and put them into the research and marketing managers. This makes a lot more sense, it's easier to manage, and is much cleaner.
Clean like the top of my head.
It might be a bit in vain since I'm probably not gonna touch either of these much and the functionality is mostly done, but at least it's better practice. Outside of game development and in the world of martial arts and tricking, my leg was feeling a little bit sore this week, so I didn't go as hard. I just worked on a variation of one of my forms and trying to include more tricking elements into that. I did a few smaller things as well that really don't have a good way of summing everything up, so I'm just gonna kind of list some stuff. For one, I added a third alien to the psychologist room. I don't know yet still if this will be the final look I'm gonna go for the aliens, but for right now, it's pretty good. I added an upgrade to increase your worker's skill, although it doesn't really have much of an impact at this point. I did a good amount of bug fixing as well, trying to fix some major issues with the worker select. For whatever reason, there seems to be like a 50% chance of you being able to actually select workers, and this has honestly been going on for a little bit. I think it's probably a layering issue, but it's kind of annoying. Why
won't you select a worker when I click on it?
For those of you still sticking around, I want to tell you guys a little bit of secret. I think I found out how to be a successful devlogger. You just gotta make a video about making devlogs, and it'll be one of your best performing videos. No, seriously, thank you so much for all the support on my year of devlogs video. I was so happy to make that, and so happy to see all the support on that. So thank you so much for that 1 year. I'm still going strong. My question is, have you played Billy's Nightmare demo? If you haven't, you should really check it out. It is a lot of fun, and I think Jonas and Fabian have done a great job so far. Thank you all for watching. I want you to know that I love you, I care for you, and I am there for you. My Discord messages are always open if you need anything at all. From me and the commanders, we are saying goodbye, and we'll see you in the next devlog.